Hi guys, this is gsndom.com and I'm here with the world's second 3D phone. So after you've seen the LG Optimus 3D, it's time to see its rival, the HTC Evo 3D. As you can see, I am using a lock screen that shows the pictures on the device. And now I have unlocked it. You can see the trademark carousel of the HTC Sense 3.0 interface that we're already familiar with from the HTC Sensation model. Now let's get right to the goods. On the front side we have a 4.3 inch 3D LCD display. It's got a QHD resolution, 540 over 960 pixels. Under the display we can see the four capacitive buttons: home, settings, menu, admin, and back and search. Now at the top we have the on off button and the audio jack. While on the left side we have the micro USB port, nothing else. On the right side we have the volume buttons that aren't quite easy to press, the 3D button, 3D 2D, and the camera button. Nothing at the bottom. While at the back we have the dual camera, dual 5 megapixel camera with dual LED flash, 3D capture, the logo, and a nice grip of the surface. Okay, so this was the 3D view of the device. You probably want to know that it's 12.1 millimeters thick, it weighs 170 grams, the HTC Evo 3D. Also it comes with 1 GB of RAM, 1 GB of internal storage, sadly. We hope they had that fixed since Sensation. It also got a micro SD port for extra memory, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, 3G. Its display is 3D, as I said, you'll see that in a minute. It takes 3D pictures at 2 megapixel resolutions, stereoscopic of course. Also, it's got a front camera, 1.3 megapixel camera, in case you're wondering, for video calls. And the classic already, dual core CPU, 1.2 GHz, that we also saw on the Sensation. The battery should last for about 7 hours of talk time. And now let's see the basic features. We've got the phone feature. I have synchronized my Google contacts, so there's a huge list of them. I've also synchronized my email. I'm going to show you immediately. This is Android 2.3 with HTC Sense, nothing you haven't seen before. So this is a Gmail with the emails I'm receiving on my account right now. Click one, send it to whoever you want. Archive it. I also have a bunch of widgets, as you can see right here, my shelf. I have the calendar right here with all the important events highlighted. These are Facebook events, since they're connected. I can also connect my Google account. This is the weather widget, that's already classic for HTC devices. You can go to someplace else. It's raining in London, nothing unusual, very nice effects, especially for this 3D phone. And other than that, as you can see, I'm using the power widget here. I also have Twitter installed, I have a song, and I'm going to show you some more widgets. These are the widgets you can get: music, larger Twitter, YouTube. Of course, the customization is available. As usual, on a new generation HTC phone, you can change the scene, focus on socializing, focus on work, or whatever you want. You can change the skin for another look of your device. Also, you can change the lock screen if you want. This is the one that I have right now, photo album. I can choose a friend stream, weather, and whatever I want to display. Okay, so as I said, Android 2.3 with Gingerbread, the classic notification area at the top. Now we're going to listen to some music, see what the speakers can do on this handset. Let's turn out the volume. A list of artists available here. Okay, you figure that one out. And now I'm going to show you the internet to see how the page is, or our page is loading. For now it's entering Google. We're connected to a 3G SIM in the inside the device, but right now we're getting edge speeds, so don't get angry. And let's try to load GSM Dome. You're also seeing the virtual keyboard right now. So let's enter, as I said, GSM Dome. Here we go. Hopefully it won't take long. But as I said, on edge, it's pretty difficult to achieve impressive speeds. I'm also going to show you a bit of YouTube 3D later on. Something that I noticed immediately is that unlike the LG Optimus 3D, this device doesn't have a special 3D area with YouTube 3D, 3D camera, 3D videos, 3D games. You have to pick them up, which is not that good. Honestly, I could have used an area to get all of my features in one place, all of my 3D features. So our site loaded in full. We can get the scrolling going. It works easily, zooming as well. Google just bought Motorola, newsflash. So everything works just fine on the 4.3 inch screen. Okay, so other than that, this device also does messaging, predictably enough. I also have the My Shelf, I can read a book if I want to. There are a bunch of options to use. We are reading books. You can change the font size to the largest, continue reading, make notes, so the book reading is taken care of. These are the main home screens, the 7 home screens that are specific to Android 2.3. The weather you've already seen. Let's check out Twitter. It's a standard app. I can see who mentioned me, messages I have, and what people are tweeting about. Some options right here, nothing amazing. Also, the friend stream, already a classic feature for HTC devices. Show me what people are doing on Facebook. You can see the status updates, the photos they posted, the links they posted, the lists, some people visiting various locations, notifications, and other such stuff. I know what you're all waiting for. It's time to break loose the camera and see what it can do. I'm going to use this watch, and for now I'm going to switch to 2D mode and take a standard picture. Here it is, not that good, but this HTC has a better camera than many other HTC models. Okay, so let's see some effects. We've got distortion. As you can see, vignette, depth of field, dots, vintage, vintage warm, vintage cold. Aside from the effects, we also have these options: self timer, white balance, the resolution of the photo, 5 megapixel, widescreen, geotagging, autofocus, and other such things. We must mention that this device takes 2 megapixel 3D photos. So now I'm going to switch to 3D and see what options we have here. There are fewer options available for the photo, and settings are also fewer: image adjustments, white balance, ISO. The file format for the 3D picture is MPO or GPS. JPS, sorry, remember that. Okay, so now I'm going to switch to video capture. Here we have image adjustment, white balance, review duration, and this is the 3D video capture I'm talking about. I can switch to 2D. Sadly, a very disappointing thing that I found on this device is that it only does this 720p video capture, either in 3D or 2D, while the good old HTC LG Optimus 3D did 1080p, at least in 2D. And now I'm going to show you the gallery on this handset to see some pictures I've taken over the past days and some pictures that came with the phone. For starters, I'm going to show you the pictures that came with the phone, especially the 3D ones that are very cool. So this is a 3D picture that comes with the device. Another one. They look stunning. I'm surprised that I can zoom in a 3D picture, but that's okay. So now I'm going to get back and show you the pictures I have taken. There's also a video thrown in there. Let's start with some 3D pictures taken by yours truly. This is 3D, taken by me. Yet another 3D shot. Great colors. As I said, a premium camera for HTC, finally. And now I'm going to show you some 2D shots. These also look cool. And finally, some videos, we can't forget that. Let's first see a 2D video and then a 3D video. Some people were complaining about the audio quality of the capture on the device, but it seems to be perfect, at least for me. You can hear the water, no problem whatsoever. Okay, enough of that. Time for some 3D capture. Let's say this one. You see some cute roses. The 3D is pretty obvious, even in front of the camera. That beautiful rose bush was pictured greatly. So the 3D camera is great on this device. Too bad that it's only in 720p. Imagine what it could have done in 1080p. But honestly, I prefer the LG Optimus. And now I'm going to show you, since the HSDPA is activated on this model, I can finally show you some 3D YouTube. I know you're craving for that. Here it is. There's a stunning video that you must see, the 3D sun, in case you don't know it already. And here we go. I really love this video, and you surely love it too, since it underlines the potential of the 3D display at its maximum. Please be patient with us and wait for the clip to load. Here we are. The sun surface should appear any minute now, and prepare to be very impressed. This is real 3D, folks. Impressive? I thought so. So that's why I showed this to you. Okay, so let's see what else we have, what else we missed. I'll show you the socializing, the weather, the Twitter, the media player. Of course, there are other standard apps that you don't need to be shown, like the calculator. Of course, we have FM radio, worry not. I can also show you the maps, no harm in that. Considering the great display on the device, the map experience is going to be great. As you can see, for yourselves, you can add some more layers, you can see some coffee spots in my area. You can get directions to it if I want. Let's see, walking navigation. It's loading. Here's the route I have to follow to reach the place I'm going. 1.1 kilometers, searching for GPS, so you can easily use the device as a GPS, as shown right here. which is pretty cool. But it's available on tons of other devices, so it's not out of the ordinary. Okay, the time has come for me to show you some of the apps on this handset, but before another look at the back, and I want to just say that it reminds me of an old cassette recorder, or should I say a Walkman, an old school Walkman device from its back. It's not as pretty as the LG Optimus 3D, to be honest, but that one was bulky. Okay, so enough about that. It's time for the applications. And let me start with one that you're going to use in the future instead of a wallet. Let's hope I can find it faster. Here it is, PayPal. I just have to enter my password, so please wait for it. Okay, here we are. We're logging in. This PayPal app is very cool. It shows my primary balance. I can send money. I can request money. I also have my account with history. I can withdraw money, recommend this app. And finally, some cool tools. For example, the bump phones. This is exactly what the name says. One guy buys a pizza, you have a phone with PayPal, he has another phone, you bump them together like this and you transfer money. Easy as it goes. You're in a restaurant and you also have the bill calculator, you can split the bill with euro, tip, total people, so it should be a blast. It's cool that when I exit the app, I also get the option to log out for security reasons, so I really like this application. Let's see what else can I show you. 3D bowling. It's not 3D at all, but the name sure is catchy. Let's choose this one and have a bowl. I couldn't leave you without games. Sadly, just like HTC Sensation, Gameloft's HD games aren't working on the QHD display. Not yet, at least. Okay, so we're down with bowling. Let's try another sport that doesn't require too many athletic skills. Pool. Pool comes in at pretty strange resolution. As you can see, it doesn't take the full screen, but that's the game. What can I do about it? The opponent seems stronger. One ball is inside already. The AI is set on easy. I guess it's my turn. Let's shoot at random. Okay, so nothing happened. Let's leave the game. Okay, so the ending has come. It's time to draw the conclusions, and I'm going to leave you with the beautiful weather effects for that, to feast your eyes on them. This is a solid device that I really enjoy testing. It has the best camera on an HTC phone I have seen, and HTC usually does poor cameras, so that's not too much bragging. I prefer the LG Optimus 3D. Both have the same price, at least on the local market. But the LG Optimus 3D has a 3D area, with YouTube, with videos, with games. This one doesn't. It's hard to find specific apps for it. Also, the video capture wasn't as impressive as the one on the LG Optimus 3D. On the plus side, it didn't tire my eyes. The LG Optimus 3D made my eyes tired. So, if you're an HTC fan, this is a must buy. If you haven't had a dual core phone yet, once again, a must buy. So you should consider this model this summer. This is GSM Dom, and I hope you like the review. Goodbye.